Much love to all.
The murders started a week after the police report was filed. After further interrogations, they confessed to beating up a number of unknown homeless men with clubs and their fists and feet, but insisted that none of them ever died and denied any involvement with the actual murders. Police kept them in custody for 19 days, as they were all certain they were the killers. However, they were released on December 2, 2006 due to a combination of lack of evidence tying them to the other crimes, and the fact that the attacks didn't stop while they were detained. On January 6, 2007, Humphrey Brandenstein, 48, was stabbed to death with an unknown weapon when we tried to intervene in another attack being committed against a homeless man by four people. Police later arrested one of the killers but quickly concluded that it was an unrelated incident and charged the one person they arrested for only Humphrey's murder. The murders still occurred in 2008, but we can't seem to find any notable cases from that year. Another murder happened that shocked the nation on June 5, 2009. An 11-year-old boy discovered the body of another decapitated homeless man at the entrance of an apartment building in Paramaribo. He was identified as 34-year-old Dennis Jonah. Police identified the murder weapon as an axe again and also formed a search party to try and find the body's head, but they never recovered it. This one sent shockwaves throughout Suriname and rekindled people's fears over the murders. People described Jonah as having done nothing wrong and wouldn't hurt a fly. The murders stopped some year between 2010 to 2014. Several of the victims have gone unidentified, and police put the number of official victims at 12 to 15 but admit that there very well could be more, as well as an unknown number of attacks that have surviving victims. There are three main theories about who the killer could be. Theory number one. That this is all the act of one person. And due to the different ways they were all killed, police also have trouble believing this. The next two theories are the ones that the police serious investigate. And if it is a serial killer, what would his motive be? Fame, notoriety, just for fun, or maybe even a hatred towards homeless people. Theory number two. That it is a gang committing these killings and that the four teenage suspects could very well have been a part of something bigger. This would also explain why the methods of murder vary. Theory number three. That the killings are ritualistic in nature, as two of the murders had no blood at the scene, leaving investigators to speculate that it could have been collected to be used in some sort of ritual. This would also account for a witness describing a suspect as being of Creole descent, as Suriname still has several tribes with superstitious beliefs.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.